Oh. Yeah, like I said, there's about 10, 20 second delay. So we should be live now. Thank you everyone for joining today's session. Today we have Ryan from Bowen Met Stahl. Sorry for the pronunciation.
Yeah, that's fine.
And also today with us, we have David from Idea Statica, who will be joining you for the conversation later on. Thank you all for attending. We'll just wait for a couple more people to sign in before we start the session. Just a bit about today's webinar session. It's going to focus on Cranberry IDEA, which is an open source Grasshopper plugin developed by Ryan, or headed by Ryan, as part of his Smart Connection research project. So with that, I just want to introduce the speakers today, or so panel. So we have Ryan. Ryan's an engineer based in Delft. He works at ABT halftime, and also Bruin Metzdau, also halftime with the research aspect. He's currently, yeah, like I said, he's currently working as an engineer at ABT, and he'll be presenting the Cranberry IDEA plugin that basically interfaces Cranberry 3D with IDEA Statica. On the panel, we also have David from IDEA Statica, who's based in Brno. He's also a structural engineer with over 10 years of working experience, and he works currently as a project engineer for IDEA Statica, but he's going to be joining the development team in a couple of weeks. So thank you all once again for attending and joining our session. Just a quick note to everyone, during the presentation, feel free to write or any comments or questions, or you can post them in this Q&A part here in the Teams, and we'll try to address them during the session and either at the end or during the presentation. So with that, I'll give it to Ryan.
Yes, let me start with setting it up.
Oops, yep.
Sure. Okay. If you're right. Well,
Yes.
thank you, Matthew. And let me start with saying thank you to you and Clemens for inviting me, giving me the opportunity to present my research on one of your webinars. The Cranberry 3D user group is an important audience to present my research to. So my name is Reanne Hughes, and as Matthew already mentioned, I work at Bouwmestaal. Bouwmestaal is the branch organization representing the Dutch steel construction industry. And our main objectives are to promote the use of steel as a structural material and to promote the productivity within our industry. So what we do, we organize events, we organize courses to educate people, we make educational books, we have a magazine and so on. And there I'm working as a researcher, and I'm conducting the Smart Connection research project. And for the other 50% of my time, I'm working at ABT, which is a Dutch multidisciplinary engineering firm. And what we do is we do everything around the designing a building except for the architectural design. So we have departments in building physics, insulation, facade engineering, and structures. And by offering our services on a multidisciplinary level, we try to provide the client with solutions which are in the best interests of the project instead of a certain discipline. So what am I going to talk about today? First of all, I'm going to introduce to you the Smart Connection Research Project, because in there was the motivation to produce this tool. And afterwards, I will show Cranberry IDEA. That was what you were coming, where you came from for. And in this presentation, I will describe three workflows, one analytical and two with IDEA Statica, in which the first one is with templates, which will be the most usable workflow because it involves no programming at all. And the second one is with program templates. So this involves a little bit of programming. So let's start with the why of the Smart Connection Research Project. It actually all has to do with this story. Imagine this is the design process of a steel structure for the utility building industry. And clients want a certain building. So the architect makes an architectural design, and after the structural engineer helps to make a structure which is strong, stiff, and stable enough for the occurring loads. And in here, the engineer is responsible of selecting the appropriate cross-sections, which are in respect with the architectural demands. So at this moment, expectations are set for the architect. So they will do their work and adjust floor levels and ducts and ventilations based on these cross-sections. But when steel connections are not sufficiently being taken into account by the engineer, and the engineer has, for example, optimized the structure to cut the most weight, surprises might occur. And especially when these surprises are negative, they're the worst. So, because in a later stage of the design process, the steel contractor is responsible for the detailing. However, this detailing can be governing for the selection of the cross sections. For example, in a bolt connection, the connection may not have the physical space which is needed to create a structurally sufficient bolt connection, or local failure mechanisms are governing for the cross sections, like local buckling failures, and can create the need for a bigger cross section. So if a bigger cross section is needed in order to make the structure buildable, we can have a problem, because the architecture or the architect did their work based on the expectations of the previous cross sections. So bigger cross sections might result in clashes with the architectural demands. Redesign may be needed, which delays the project delivery, and you need to put work into it where your company is probably not getting paid for. So finally, resulting in a mediocre product. Client is not happy, architect's not happy, actually nobody is happy. So what we want to achieve is we want to, our goal is to stimulate the integration of detail analysis into the optimization process by first of all creating understanding and acknowledging that these risks might occur. So we try to develop and provide the knowledge and the tools needed to make this integration possible. So we integrate steel connections in a smart way into the optimization process, eventually streamlining the design process by decreasing the risk of failure costs and allowing us to add more quality to our designs projects, making the client happy, making actually everybody happy at the end of the project. So the research has a technical part to it. It's actually how you can integrate these two levels of structural analysis into one model, where you have one global structure and you retrieve like all connections, assess them, check the results, and eventually you put all results into a cost model. And then you can do the same type of analysis where you change the grids compared to the typical weight optimization analysis. The research also has a non-technical part, which is basically spreading the word, so giving presentations, also like this webinar right here today, creating the tools needed to make this easy accessible for everybody. We are also working together with Idea Statica, because we have this common goal. They also want to be able to optimize connections on costs. Within the research, we also have a YouTube channel, and there you can find videos on my research, like the most recent one is the cost optimization of an embraced steel frame structure. So I would like to recommend you to go and watch it. We also started giving courses in parametric design, also to educate everybody within our industry in having this new tool to design structures. And what we did last year was we organized a hackathon in which we tried to integrate like all these disciplines. So teams were set in which every team consists at least one architect, one structural engineer, and one detail engineer. And in a short time span of 6 hours, they had to design a hockey stadium. So that was great fun. And we were planning to do a second one this year, but due to the coronavirus, we can't. So we hope to be back in 2021 with the second edition of the hackathon. The big question that you might ask yourself is, why did we develop Caramba IDEA? Because we are not part of Caramba 3D and also not from IDEA Statica. As mentioned before, Caramba 3D is a tool, the most easy accessible tool for parametric optimization problems. And it's so easy to use because it's embedded in Grasshopper, and therefore you have a direct results in Grasshopper itself. So providing this user group with a tool that actually can help them evaluate connections would be very useful. And during my graduation project, I also made a big Grasshopper script which could optimize trusses with steel connections. So refactoring all that code into an actual plugin that people could use was, seemed like quite a logic step. So why did I choose IDEA Statica in this combination? IDEA Statica has an API, which is of course needed to send information to it and retract information back again. And secondly, IDEA Statica possesses the flexibility to cope with parametric connections, which is of course needed in a parametric workflow. So, but please keep in mind that Caramba and IDEA Statica are chosen as a combination, but it's more about the framework behind that and the information scheme and the class structure in which information is saved. And Caramba IDEA is actually the product to that methodology. And this is actually the methodology we want to achieve in cost analysis workflows. So within Caramba 3D, you actually have two types of workflows, one through analytical models and one through IDEA Statica calculations. And what you basically have is you have your global model. And in this model, you already define certain information, and then you extract every connection and do the analysis. But when your connection is validated and it's structurally good enough, you also have extra information like the welding volume, bolts, plates, saw and cuts. And in the final stage, you can do the cost assessment. So you can combine all this information with cost parameters and have actually a total price in which you can give a number to the performance of your variant. And if you do that for a big data set, you can actually basically choose which is the cheapest one according to your parameters. So what we're doing, we go a little bit further than just staying with the global model. And you can see that costs of joints are added, and also that the cost of beams are being changed, and that's because in here the beams are going from node to node, and when you actually design it with a connection, some beams will become longer and some will become shorter, like the beams here in the middle, which will cause a different price. So what Caramba IDEA does, it's extract all information from a Caramba 3D model and makes a project out of it. And you still need to add some information in order to have a project that you can need for detail analysis. So here you can see that a hierarchy is added in a panel. And the hierarchy is needed because you want to influence which sections are continuous and which are ended. So in Caramba 3D, you can assign different groups of elements like top chord, bottom chord, diagonal column. And by setting the hierarchy in a certain way, you can influence in what way what element will be continuous or not. So for this one, the column is highest in a hierarchy, offers top chord and then bottom chord. So if you go to this example, you see that the column is highest, so this one's continuous, and the bottom chords are ended. And if you change the hierarchy to this one, for example, the top chord is the highest in hierarchy. Secondly, the bottom chord and after the column. So if you apply this hierarchy, you will be able to design the connection in such a way where this is the continuous member. And hierarchies are actually everywhere in steel structures. So in here you can see that, for example, the red members are higher in hierarchy than the blue. So let's start to take a look at the download page. What I just did is I uploaded a new version which has all the functionalities of what I'm going to present today. IDEA Statica helped me with updating it. So here are some new files. You can download the cross profile here, and please make sure that you have all the DLLs within the folder. There are also examples to be found which can be downloaded here. But I'll go to the GitHub page, because Caramba IDEA is an open source project, which means that you can just use the source code and update it to your liking. So it's just free to for you to take it there. And in here you can also find the Grasshopper files, which are in the examples. So if you have experience with programming in C#, I would recommend you just to clone the repository, and all information, the most updated information, can be found there. So in here you can also find some documentation about how the script is working. So here we have a big UML diagram, which is basically the framework behind Caramba IDEA, which I was just talking about. So take a look at that if you want have trouble understanding the GitHub page. So let's start opening Caramba IDEA. So I'll open the folder because I have the repository on my local drive. And for example, we're gonna look at this example. And what you can see in the example is that with different colors, I highlighted different pieces of my code. So in green, you see the geometry aspect. In red, you see the Caramba piece. And then afterwards, you have the Caramba IDEA part. So if you go to the head ribbon and you look at Caramba IDEA, you see many different subfolders. So the most important one is this, the big boy here, which is responsible of collecting all information and making a project out of it. And furthermore, we have some utilities. So what we can see here is one for joint equilibrium. You can check basically if there is equilibrium in your connections at every level, which is great for debugging purposes. So let's put this one to the side and put this one on this perspective. So what we can also do is we can check like local coordinate systems and check if they are placed in the right direction. And the last project utility tool I want to show you is visualizing the joints. So what you see here is all the joints that are occurring in this project. And what you can see here are certain brand names. And these brand names are the combination of the index number of the hierarchy. So this number is 014, which is the column, the top chord, and the diagonal. And having this number will allow you to identify similar connections. And when you identify similar connections, you can treat them in the same way, because these need to be worked out in the same manner. So changing, for example, the truss to where the columns are have a bending moment will change this. Will change the type of connections that you have. Also, like increasing the number of connections to a really dense one will also change it. So let's start with the first demo of the analytical connections. And that is this one, portal frame. So what you can see here is I created a Grasshopper component which contains information of a certain connection, which in this case is a moment resisting connection. And in there I included attributes which will give a certain which will influence the connection. For example, stiffeners can be applied and things like that. So I will describe it with this one because I created three of these analytical connections just to show you guys. We'll connect this one to here. Then we'll change the type of cross sections. And you might see that that a certain connection is being created because this is an optimization algorithm for thin plate connections. And what you can see here is that a little optimization procedure is being run for every connection in the project, which is actually based on the height of the cross section and the occurring shear forces. Afterwards, the costs are calculated because you have the information needed to make a cost assessment. So you know your total weight of all your elements. So this is basically the list of the elements you have, but also the weight of plates. And this is per connection, the weight of each plate, and also for welding volume. And chain calculating or multiplying these values with a certain unit price will eventually give you a cost per joint, which is also displayed here. So this is also parametric. So when you change certain cross sections, you can see that also the cost parameters are being changed. And what you can also see is that in some cases, a solution does not occur because it cannot find, but it optimizes based on this procedure, which is defined. And if you want to take a closer look into this procedure, within the GitHub page, there are three folders, Coramba IDEA, which are all the Grasshopper scripts, the core, which is the framework working on the background, and the IDEA Statica scripts. So if you open this one, you see the same folders as in the plugin, and you can look here at analytical templates, thin plates, and it will give you more insight on the procedure which is being done in optimizing these thin plate connections. So just to give you an impression where we want to head to with the research project, and I'll get back to the truss again. So what we have here is we have our project again, and we sent our project to one of our IDEA Statica utilities. So we basically have two. One is creating an IDEA Statica file, which is simple, and the other one is creating and also calculating. So I'll disable these parts because we will talk about these later. Then combine the project again. It's always good practice. So after you make the change to rerun script, and then we'll hit the button for this. You can select a connection, but we will select, I'll just have to change this one to be hinged. We select this connection, we hit a button, And what will happen is that the file is being created in the background. So in the specified folder, you see here that the Statica file is being created. So it takes some time for it to open. And what you can see here in the background are two XML files, IOM file, which stands for the IDEA Open Model, which is the name of the API of IDEA Statica. This first file contains all data of the connection, and the second one contains all the results coming from Caramba 3D, like the shear forces and bending moments, stuff like that. So here we have our connection. And what we can do is we can, of course, apply operations. But if we have a set of operations, we can make a template out of it. So what I did is I already made a template for this connection. And we can apply it, and then we have a connection that we actually can calculate with. But we can also extract this template file. So we can find it, for example, here. And we can save it somewhere. So let's save it here. Let's get to the folder. To the local file. There's like a template. And here we have it. So if you open this one, you see the contemp file that you actually need to assign a template to a connection. And I basically did that for this connection. So let's try and apply this. So enable this one. Sign this one, so it will basically load the template that I just talked about and apply it to the location 014. So let's rerun it again and hit the calculate and create and calculate button and just see what happens. So meanwhile, this is the old one. So let's get back to the C drive, to the data, and check out where the connections is being created. It's already there. We already have the results. And this takes some time, like 30 seconds, 40 seconds or something. It also depends on the complexity of the connection, of course. So after a little while, results will pop up.
Maybe while it's calculating, if there's any questions from any of the attendees, please feel free to post it in the Q&A. Maybe Clemens might also have a question in the meantime while we wait for it to.
Oh, too bad, Clemens. Okay, so we have our Unity checks, and we basically have the result of our connection. So what we do is we can open it just to get a look at it. Oh yeah, what I actually forgot is what I wanted to do was change the geometry to a different geometry and then run the calculation again, and then you can actually see the difference in between the previous and new connection. So let's do that for the sake of illustration. Clemens, if you have a question, we can address it.
Yes, in fact, I have one question. You export now the cross-section forces to IDEA, and that's then the basis for the design of the welds and of the connection as a whole. But does it also take So this difference is not taken into account. So
the stiffness of the connection itself.
Right. Yeah, and the stiffness of the surrounding structure, because the relation between the two might a little bit change the cross-section forces, actually. Probably not much most of the time, but
What it does, it will just send through all the information defined in Caramba. So mm-hmm. what you determine in Caramba will be sent to Idea Statica.
Yeah.
And that's basically it.
Okay.
So go on, let's open. Okay, so we have it here. Sorry for the delay. So what we change the number of numbers of trusses, or the segmentation in the truss. You see that the angle of the diagonal has changed. And the why we would do that is because in all the loads from Caramba 3D are exported as well. And these loads are always in equilibrium. And this is very useful if you work do it in this matter, because you will always have a changed geometry, but also with the forces that are occurring in that changed geometry. So what you can also see is that when this was actually the first one and this is the second one, is when you change the geometry, you also have other options for your bolts to be placed. So like parametric connections, I would like to see them as like second order parametric things, because they are depending on the second order on your parametric model. So making like really good parametric templates which can cover all these alterations will make it quite a challenging sport. So we talked about the templates, and you can assign these templates, but you can also assign like programmed templates, which are these ones. So I defined two, and this one is the one which will weld all connections to one another. And if I select a different connection, I can show you what it looks like. For example, this middle one, it will go into calculation again. And what I can show is where you can find these connections inside the repository.
Ryan, yeah. Just a couple of questions from the attendee. Rick asked, he said basically, nice presentation, Ryan, very, very cool stuff. Two questions. Will the 30 to 40 seconds runtime be reduced in the future? So for quicker analysis of connections, let's say you want to batch analyze 10 types of connections. What is your opinion about this?
Yeah, you can make an iteration out of it. The next demo and final demo will be an iteration procedure. But at the end, like every variant you need to calculate just takes some time. So it's in the time span of around 40 seconds. Yeah, it depends on the complexity of the connection, of course. But if you have like a procedure of like, let's say 20 variants, it just takes some time before you have all your results. So you have to be patient for that. So if you have a really big data set you want to investigate, it will just take some time. I cannot make anything else out of that. So if we go to the IDEA folder, we also have a file called templates. And what you can see here is a combination, is code which represents, let's show it in Visual Studio, it's much easier. It's here. So there are workshop operations like you have in the user interface. So if you combine these operations in the right manner, you can actually also apply templates. And I included these templates in one of these connections, and one of those templates is actually this one. And I can see that I do not have any results, so it might be good to like reload this component element again.
And so this templates, they include all the rules according to your code regarding the placement of the bolts and so on, and actually set up the finite element model on which ETS Statica is then based. Is this correct?
No, it does not include the rules of the Eurocode, but it includes rules of how the template will be set up with workshop operations. So it depends, it decides whether a certain cross-section will be cut and how it will be connected, will be with a weld. So you kind of determine that all in this component. And so, yeah, something is not working accordingly. So I'll just add further with my presentation and I will show it on the other demonstration. So what you can also do is when you have multiple templates, you can add a new template with a different color and assign this to a different spot. So let's see what kind of connections we still have left. So let's assign this to 1134. And you can basically assign this another template to another location. So if you kind of assign templates to all locations, you can basically calculate the whole structure and all connections if everything is set down right. I'll head forward to the final demo. And then afterwards you can wrap up. So the next one is this one, tensile connection. And but this is a very simple one. So you have actually two beams with a bolt connection in between. And this bolted connection also contains attributes, which is the thickness of the plates. So I'll set a certain thickness to it and calculate it. And in here also the same procedure. It will take a certain template, which is composed out of different workshop operation commands. But in if you compare it to the previous workflow with templates, you can actually specify certain attributes, which you can make parametric. And in this case, I made the thickness of the plate parametric. And what you can do afterwards is, so you have our results here. And we can also take a closer look into the file over here. And it will show you that the plates which we just set to 90 millimeters will actually also be 90 millimeters in the ETS Statica file. So also take some time to open. Sorry for that. So what I did here is I made an Colibri iteration procedure, and what it does, it will iterate through the thickness of the plate, and at every variant it will store like the unity checks and also store a price. And with this procedure you can actually analyze how the thickness of the plate influences the performance of the connection. So this is actually what we just made. And here you can see a thickness of 19 millimeters. So let's get back to this presentation. So we went through these things. I also can add, give you the sheets if needed at the end of the lecture. So in here, I did the iteration procedure. And on the bottom axis, you see the thickness of the plate, which is increasing. In orange, you can see the unity checks of the bolts. And in blue, it is the strain percentage of the plate. And what you can see here from the orange line is how the connection is evolving from mode 1-2 to mode 3. So where it kind of flattens, the plate becomes so thick that it doesn't, that prying forces don't occur anymore. And because you want the deformation capacity in your connection, you want to have it inside one value mode one or value mode two. So in this case, you can actually see at what moment that this is occurring. Still, you can see that the unit checks or the bolts are still exceeded. So what could be an outcome of this like small investigation is that you should increase the bolts and you can do the iteration again and see if the information capacity is there in your connection. So this is a really small example. And you can actually extend this routine to be way more complex, in which you change your tensor connection with the number of bolts if it fails. And if it still fails, you increase the plate, eventually even add binders if needed or add grips. So you have this routine on a detail level. You can include this one again in a global optimization process. For example, a truss with multiple segments. And eventually you can run this whole procedure and optimize your complete structure on costs, transport dimension of hoisting capacities. So just to give an idea on what could be done with it. So as I explained, there are kind of two routes in Caramba IDEA, one with an analytical template and one with IDEA Statica templates. They both have advantages and disadvantages. So the analytical are quick. It stimulates the use of Eurocode because you have to code them yourself. They are less applicable for unique configurations. And yeah, this might be redundant to say, but non-defined failure mechanisms will not be checked. So if you forget one of these failure mechanisms, you might end up getting the wrong solutions. IDEA Statica also has advantages and disadvantages. Many failure mechanisms are checked automatically. It has a more accurate stress distribution, possibility to analyze complex joint configurations. It's validated, but on the other hand, it can introduce singularities in strange configurations. It has peak stresses and computational time is relatively long. So what I'm expecting it to be in the future is that you will not use one of the two, but you will use a combination of both, in which at the beginning you have like this big forest of different options and you kind of cut most of the trees by using your analytical procedure. And then if you have five trees left in your forest, you analyze these five with IDEA Statica just to make your optimization procedure as efficient as possible. So to recap, what did we talk about today? We talked about analytical connections. We talked about IDEA Statica templates, how do you implement them in your workflow. And also we talked about programmed templates. And with this tool, we try to reach this goal of stimulating the use of connection analysis into the optimization process. So if you want to be part of developing Caramba IDEA, it's an open source project and you can access it. It's available for you to use. And if you want to be part of the community and build your own new template components, feel free to do so and send a merge request. So I'm really enthusiastic and looking forward to what your applications with Caramba IDEA will be. And if you have nice cases to show me, send me an email and I will be happy to see or read it. And thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Ryan, for the great presentation. I mean, we're a little bit over time, but I think there's a few questions that people definitely have. So if you don't mind, we'll ask them now. If there's also other questions from the audience, please feel free to ask them. David already addressed part of this question. Someone was asking, does Caramba IDEA calculate the performance of screws, bolts, and pins? In the case of the joint is welded, does it calculate it too? And so maybe David could also provide some insight into this, or Ryan too.
Yes, I can clarify this question. So I answered to one of our users, but in IDEA Statica, so after you export your connection to IDEA Statica, you are able to design and code check any kind of topology and connection. So welded, bolted, anchoring, really trusses, everything. So it's without limits.
Yeah. To add something to the question is, in Coramba 3D, you determine which connections will be hinged or moment resisting. And eventually this will create or cause that a bending moment is occurring in certain cross section. So as a user, you should keep this in mind in order to have a good application of your structural engine analysis into combined with how your connection actually gonna look like. So these need to be consistent with one another. So hinge connections will not attract the bending moment, and if it does, it will. So keep that in mind.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for the answer. And then Rick was also asking, I think it's a typo, but I think he's asking if you can also create the reports in Grasshopper that are usually generated in Dia. I'm assuming that this is similar in the case of the question before, that this is generated in Dia itself, but maybe Ryan, you can elaborate on this.
Yeah, it's a good question. Yeah, you can see the API of IDEA Statica as a raw diamond that still needs to be polished. And with that, I mean that not everything which is available in the user interface is already available in the API. So, for example, exporting the PDFs, the reports, is one of the things which is not available yet. So it will be probably in the future, but hopefully. yeah, it's something we have to, which takes time, so that the API like grows in its functionality.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Clemens, do you actually have a question?
Yes, I have a question. And thank you very much for your great talk. One question. I mean, at the moment, the cross-section optimization of Coramba is totally unaware of how the connection is detailed. So I think it would be probably a good thing to combine this with the joint design, so that the two are aware of each other, so to say. So do you think it would be helpful? I mean, at the moment, the users can set the joint conditions and stiffnesses, but actually, this should actually be also made part of the optimization. Do you think that this would be somehow possible? I mean, to define.
Yeah, I am. Like with the stiffness, you can actually retrieve stiffnesses from IDEA Statica normal in the user interface, but this is also not available in the API yet. However, I made a video on my YouTube channel with how this procedure would work with the analytical templates. So with Eurocode, I made a calculation of the stiffness by the simplified component method. And in this procedure, you first calculate the design structure, then you design the connections, you retrieve the stiffnesses and implement that in a second calculation. And then you have taken both into account into your optimization procedure. So I would like to advise people watching to watch that video, because it gives you a good explanation on how this procedure would look like and how it would work. And eventually, the idea is to upgrade this with and replace the analytical template with IDEA Statica, because the accuracy is a lot higher.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because one thing which I saw is if you want to calculate, for example, the deflections of a bolted structure, that's actually not so easy, because there's always a tolerance between the bolt and the hole, so there will occur some slip until the whole thing gets stuck somehow, but it's very hard to get a good displacement response out of a bolted steel structure. So this would be extremely helpful if things like this could be somehow integrated into the joint or connection analysis.
Yeah, great. Yeah, this is a good advice. It's great.
Thank you for that, Clemens. I'm just checking if there's any other final questions. At the moment, there doesn't seem to be. Maybe I have also just a general question, maybe to David itself. I myself am not so familiar with Idea Statica, and I'm not sure, for example, if the users of Idea Statica are working with parametrics or platforms such as Grasshopper, and sort of what's your sort of experience in working with parametric softwares and interfacing with these different programs. And for example, how would then Cranberry Idea, this plugin that Ryan has developed, how would you imagine this sort of building on top of the whole program development?
Yes, this is how we call it, third-party software. So Grasshopper and Caramba, we maintain, or directly, we maintain a few softwares, Beamlinks. And because it's not possible to maintain all the softwares all over the world, so we developed this, we call it IDEA Open Model, IOM, and it's available on GitHub. If you go to our webpage, www.idea.com, and you write label IOM, so you will find something about it, and you will find a link to GitHub. So therefore, we developed this open source, and with this possibility, third or other third-party softwares are able to connect to IDEA Statica. So with this IOM, you can export your connection to IDEA Statica and code check it. And maybe the second part of the question is parametric designs. We don't focus on parametric design in IOM, and that's true, it's not part of it just now, because we develop our own, let's say, parametric templates, and we have several tools directly in IDEA Statica, wizard and so on, and we develop these possibilities directly in our software.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's why I think it's a very, very good opportunity for like third parties such as Ryan to develop these tools which work with your API systems that can then interface with different platforms, and I think that's a really great opportunity. I'm not sure if there's any final questions or comments from any of you, Clemens, David, or Ryan. Otherwise, I don't want to take too much extra time. Oh, actually, one last question just came up.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Are you able to run multiple connection calculations in parallel, or is it happening in a series?
Oh, that's a good question. It's not parallel, because it involves a lot of better programming work. So how it's programmed is pretty simple and straightforward. But if you want to upgrade it in that way, that would be really useful. As mentioned, it's open source. So use that part to start off with. Try to upgrade it using these parallel computation techniques, because it will reduce computational time a lot. And if you manage, please let us know. Send a merge request. That would be a great implementation.
Yes, thank you for that. Any last comments from any of you three before we close off the session for today? If there's no sort of last comments, then maybe we can wrap it up for today. Thank you very much once again, for, Ryan, for showing us Cranberry Idea and the sort of workflow that you've sort of developed in your current research. I guess in the coming sort of months and years, there's also going to be a lot of new development happening. So I've just sort of shared now the contact information of Ryan and also for David, for those of you who want to get in touch, and the scripts that you showed and the plugins that you showed are all downloadable from the Fruit for Rhino website. We will be also posting this webinar session on our YouTube channel at a later date, so please feel free to share this with your colleagues once this is up. Thank you, Ryan, once again for sharing this great sort of tool that you've developed. And thank you, David, for being part of the sort of discussion. Any last comments from you guys?
Thank you very much that you invited me. And of course, thank you for attention. It's from my side.
From Ryan, any last sort of comments that you might have?
Thank you for giving me this opportunity, and I hope that maybe this will be the start of getting our industry further and getting it to the next level, which is integrated connection into the optimization process and really get into the detail level and be able to optimize on way higher detail level. That would be nice if we can achieve that.
Yeah, definitely. I think it would be a great sort of start for this. So thank you once again to everyone who attended the webinar. It's great. Thank you for your support. And we hope to see you next time for another webinar session in a couple of weeks. So stay informed on our website. And we hope to see you all very soon. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Ryan and David. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.